Hi, my name's Paul Greenier, and I'm a volunteer with the Martin Fleischmann Memorial Project. So over the lunch break, we took a look at this area on the copper tube, which was eaten by a ball lightning, 10 millimeters, but off to the one side, the sort of blow off to the side, which probably was the original tube that was in the center, which basically disappeared. And so we did a map of that, and here it is. And it's in an area which has got a lot of disruption, so we can't necessarily tell much from it. But I will share this image, but you can see that it's quite nice. And I think we're going to have a quick look to see what these structures are. These function structures in here are a little bit more funky, and we can have a look at that. It does look like some sort of field going on there. But anyway, you can have a look around this actual ledger. There are these kind of clusters that we see in the Vega Valley, and there are clusters of clusters. So it is an interesting deep pixel image for people to look at, but this really does look interesting here. Some sort of flow going on there. Again, more kind of clusters here start to look like areas of the Vega Valley, and that's maybe not so surprising because you do have some zinc and some copper in here. Some structures here that look a little bit like they might be, this is quite cute. This is a hollow ball with things sticking out of it. That's really rather cute. Anyway, don't know what else we might find, but you can look at this in your own time. Again, hollow areas, balls. Here we go, nice ball here. What's this ball? Is that a crenellated sphere? Maybe. Was that a crenellated sphere under there? Who knows? Did that come out of there? Are they related? Who knows? Okay, I'm going to have a look at maybe this area here and some of these areas here. Got to be a challenge to find that, so we'll just find something interesting to look at. Well, that looks interesting, doesn't it? Have a look at that. Not a lot of dates in there. Thank you. almost looks like here you've got these point emitters and it's forming clusters on the top, and on the clusters you have possibly copper. Is that what's going on here? I don't know. There might be car. Let's find out. Seems to have a different elemental constitution down its length. I think we want a line square length, but we don't need so many lines. No. What are all these round balls? What is this round ball? With a hole in it. That's a surprise. Potassium carbonate. Okay. Do you have the air can?
Sorry?
Do you have the air can?
No.
Thank you. Lots of holes. What would make holes? Bubble blowing? Isn't that cute? An iron bubble? Copper on the outside? I don't know. This is how big. 40 microns across. This is a sphere. It would be a big one. These tips here are 6-7 microns, something like that. Let's go in and have a look at this. Hello. That's me for curling. Still curling. Well, isn't it an iron ball? It's 48% iron. Not a lot of it's getting illuminated, so I'm going to stop that. Yeah, well, I think it's getting more illumination. Yeah, so copper on the white splodges, the background is iron, and there's oxygen everywhere. Potassium on these things. So it appears there's an iron ball under there. Come on the outside. Interesting. Alright. I guess that's probably true of a lot of these balls. They're all probably the same kind of thing. Looks like the same kind of thing to me, and effectively these probably are the same kind of thing on there as well. All the same kind of thing. And with that, we may be done with this sample for today, because we've got some other things that I want to get to. Just a quick run around, see if there's anything spectacular that grabs my eye. A Christmas tree down like. Christmas tree light out here. Pretty sure this will be more of the same. Thank you. So this is something like another ball lightning cut area. Not quite as clear as our previous one. Interesting trail there though. And some hollow spheres. Like this one. What's the scale on this puppy? Oh, look at that, it's got a 1 micron shell. What are the chances? What are the chances that that would be 1 micron? You're seeing a pattern there. Sitting up on it. Pedestal. What are we looking at there? Interesting. Let's have a look at what they're saying. I'm going to get a bit of a What are we looking at here? Central thing is just 1.73 micron. This is 9 micron, 8 micron, 8.7. What have we got there? Is that iron? Yes, it's iron. There's a squidge and a copper. Iron and oxygen. Iron and oxygen. What is this? Is this iron? It's iron and oxygen. What is surrounding this one? Wow, look at that. Iron, copper, oxygen. Oxygen iron, and this one is oxygen iron. Okay, I guess this here is going to be carbon. Want to know what that tube is there. And then one last thing. It's a very white bulb here. It probably is just copper. Or zinc. Oh, carbon and oxygen. No, that one again is oxygen, iron. Wow, iron oxygen, very, very similar. This one is. Concentration of zinc. Okay, I think we're understanding this. I think, Hank, you had potassium carbonate in this experiment. Of course, we were finding quite a bit of it. And I think that's probably the reason that these things are being synthesized. Okay, this is kind of looking at the outside. And we've got one cut edge here. We're going to be able to focus on that. Probably going to be in shadow if it does. Okay. Thank you. Copper oxide on here, mixed in with some balls, probably iron ball. Okay, I think we are done for this sample. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next video.